State investigators find more than a dozen safety violations in connection with a deadly daycare van accident. Tonight, we have an exclusive interview with a former worker at that daycare who says the violations have been going on for years. WLKY Steve Tellier has the report and reaction to it.
One woman killed, another seriously injured, 14 children taken to the hospital, and one woman says she saw it coming.
I always knew that something was going to go wrong. I'm just sad and disappointed that people had to get hurt in the process.
For this former employee of Heavenly Angels Child Care, June's deadly accident involving one of the daycare's vans was sadly not shocking.
I wasn't surprised because she put no effort into making sure that the children was going to be safe.
And now a state investigation backs her up. The report states, quote, 14 children and two staff were riding in a van suitable for a maximum of 15 occupants. Several children were not properly restrained in car seats and booster seats, and two of them were thrown from the van when it slammed into a tree. It quotes a police officer as saying he was sure that children were doubled up in seats and observed that three or four children seated in the back seat of the van were sharing one lap belt. The report also notes the previous history of similar safety violations at Heavenly Angels and cites a prior pledge from the owner, Lavanya Lures. I now make sure that the maximum allowed, 13, is transported on van. I will monitor on a daily basis. That pledge has now been permanently broken.
We had 13 kids on a van. I say two or three of them had on seatbelts.
This former employee says it's not that seatbelts weren't worn, it's that they weren't even there.
It didn't have a seatbelt to restrain them. She didn't put no maintenance into those vans to make sure that those children was going to be secure.
She also claims the daycare's vans were routinely overloaded with kids.
Any way that she can cut a corner, she did.
She says Lures, who is also accused of stealing hundreds of thousands of dollars in state child care funding, was motivated by just one thing.
Money. It was always about the money for her. It was never the children.
Steve Tellier, WLKY News.
And that state report also found other violations, including the daycare's failure to immediately notify parents of the accident and the lack of any paperwork available to emergency personnel to help identify the children who were on board the van. Lures shut down all three Heavenly Angels locations just days after that accident. We couldn't reach her or her attorney for comment today.